Now playing.
This is Access Hollywood for Friday, July 11th. Matthew Perry is back from drug rehab, and today only his close friend Courtney Cox can tell you how he's doing. Plus, Cindy Crawford drops a bombshell about her ex-husband, Richard Gere. Then, you are there as one cameraman experiences sheer terror in Spain, running from the bulls.
I saw him coming, I tracked you coming. Get right at me.
And it's the Monkees. You'll be a daydream believer all over again as we take to the stage with the Monkees. Welcome to Stage 5, where we'll access Hollywood.
Sound great. Hello, everyone. I'm Giselle Fernandez.
And I'm Larry Menti, on location at Universal Studios City Walk, where three very important people are getting ready right now to take that stage. Backstage is Peter, Mickey, and Davey, the Monkees. They are back, and they are bigger than ever. You know, it's been 30 years since they stormed America with their music and their number one Emmy Award-winning television show. But they will be up on that stage performing some of their hits, and we'll be talking with the Monkees coming up. They really are nice guys, Giselle, because they're too busy playing to put anybody down.
They are busy guys. Thank you, Larry. They look great, too. Here's what's happening in Hollywood, though, today. Friends star Courtney Cox, while out promoting her...
At NBC4.
We are at Universal City Walk in Hollywood, and pretty soon we're going to catch up with the Monkees. But first, we're going to go down to Universal Studios in Florida for Hercules. Kevin Sorbo himself was on hand to unveil a brand new attraction, and he turned it into a family affair.
This is my niece, April. And this group called...
Extortionist. All right. We're going to take you back now in time for a look at one of the hottest groups from the 60s. The Monkees were recently stirring up a crowd at Universal Studios in Hollywood, and our own Larry Menti was there. As they took the stage, we'll have that for you later, but first, Larry and the Monkees take us back in time.
Here we come.
It was a cultural phenomenon, a TV show about an irreverent rock band, the Monkees.
Hey, hey, we're the Monkees.
A cult hit when it debuted in 1966, the Monkees lasted only two seasons. But its mix of Marx Brothers-like slapstick and Beatlesque music changed TV forever.
I wanna be free.
VH1 now is playing the Monkees, which seems appropriate because you kind of started this whole video craze.
I think we were one of the first people that were out there doing that kind of thing, and we had a TV show which featured two or three what we called monkey romps, which then, you know, sort of developed into what they call music videos.
Take the last train across.
From the start, the Monkees were groundbreaking. Never before had a TV show created a rock band, hiring actors to play all the parts. Peter Tork and Mike Nesmith were musicians.
You're just the one, hold my hand.
Mickey Dolenz had been a child actor, and Davy Jones was in musical theater. It was also the first show to cater to rebellious teens.
You'll never take us alive.
It was the first show of its day, and for a long, long time thereafter, to have no authority figure. And so the theme, well, for young people, right. Well, there was all, you know, it was up to then, it was like My Three Stupid Sons or Father Knows Best, You Dolt You.
Then I saw her face.
Almost immediately, the Monkees became a real band, releasing four number one albums. At the height of Monkey Fever in 1967, they even outsold the Beatles. Plus, you couldn't pick up a magazine or turn on the TV without seeing them.
Take the last train across the land.
The Monkees broke up shortly after the show was canceled in 1968. Through the years, they occasionally worked together, and in 1986 made a major comeback. These days, Davey, Mickey, and Peter still tour together, and Mike is writing a movie about the group that they'll all star in. Do you worry each time you start one of these tours, are the fans still going to be there? Are we still fresh?
We could get by with a lot cheaper and easier show if we walked out there and said, hey, you know, screw it, we'll just go out and play Clarksville and who the hell cares what it sounds like, but then it wouldn't last very long at all.
All right, the Monkees have just taken the stage in front of their screaming fans, and they will be performing one of their big hits when we come back. will it be I'm a Believer, Daydream Believer, or Last Train to Clarksville? You know them all. Which one will it be? We'll find out when we come right back.
Looks like you need a big...
Welcome back to Access Hollywood. I'm Larry Menti. It is just one of the number one songs to propel this group to superstardom. Here are the Monkees singing Daydream Believer.
Oh, I could fly beneath the wings of the bluebird as you sing. It's 6 o'clock and long for them rain. But it rains and I rise, wipe the sleep out of my eyes. My shaving razor's cold and stained. Well, you once thought of me as the white knight on his steed. Well, now you know how happy I'd be. And all the time start to end without dollar more to spend.
Tonight, a look at July. Have a great weekend, everyone. Larry's going to take us on out of here with the Monkees. Larry?
That's right, Giselle. Hey, hey, it's the Monkees, or at least it was the Monkees for us at Access Hollywood. Here they are performing Last Train to Clarksville. Goodbye from Universal Studios City Walk. I'm Larry Menti.
Tonight, a teacher throws herself in front of an out-of-control van. Brooklyn vegetable gardens tainted with lead. A whole new look for New York subways and Penn Station. Plus, a special report on gambling in Atlantic City. And we are live at a special dance party at Lincoln Center. Details coming up at 11.
Tonight at 11 on News 10.